tent. What? Trapped. He just picks up that tent, bundles it up, throws it over his bare shoulder, and strolls off into the woods whistling, smarter than the average bear.
If he's a yogi bear, then I feel like...
Well, you'd be safe against a yogi bear.
Yeah. Yeah. I don't know. At least I'd be safe. I'd be in a tree. I thought... Same way I thought maybe I could just beat a wolf. You know, like beat a...
What are these
I think about this sometimes because it might come up one day. There was a whole movie with Liam Neeson where he fought off these wolves. Yeah, and I feel like all you got to do is get in.
The wolves kidnapped his daughter and then he had to fight them? Is that what it was?
Yeah, they were very very sorry to have kidnapped his daughter by the time he got to them.
Okay, do you have a very specific set of skills?
No, mine would just be I get up close to that wolf so he's not taunting me anymore.
Okay.
And I just...
You bite him?
I grab him, probably by the cheeks.
Why do you think you could grab all these animals' faces and they wouldn't bite your hand before you get into their face?
Okay, this is actually the real... If I could do that, that would be pretty good. The second plan, or the one that's going to... You're not going to like this, but I let it grab my hand. I let it bite me and take me in. And then I just proceed by shoving the rest of my arm down its throat, and I just grab onto whatever I can. Like tonsils, the stomach lining, and pull the stomach back out.
Why do you think you could just jam your hand down the throat of a wolf?
Well, I don't know.
First of all, sharp teeth. You've got probably pretty bad deep cuts on your hand, fist, or a forearm. But now you're just going to jam your fist down its throat? You don't think it's going to recoil?
No, because
I feel like your best bet would be to grab its tongue.
No, tongues are slippery. You ever tried to grab a dog's tongue?
I have successfully several times. Freaked my dog the heck out.
Yeah.
Difficult. And she stopped biting.
Yeah, I guess so. But I'm thinking a wolf is always trying to bite things, and those things are always trying to get away. So your mistake when you get bitten by a wolf is to try and pull away, because that's what's going to cut you up and rip you off. He's not expecting you to shove your fist and hand deep into his body.
Yeah, that's true. But now you have to factor in that a wolf is usually, it's rare that it is a lone wolf. So you've got your fist deep down one wolf's throat while three other wolves are jumping out of the bush.
Well, yeah, then I'm dead.
Yeah.
But at least I'll take one wolf with me.
Okay. You could always do what my father's strategy was. When I had a dog, every now and again she would bite one of us.
Okay.
She was young. She was playing a little too rough, basically.
Yeah.
So my dad ended the dog biting us once and for all. He grabbed her, bit her on the snout, and she went, yup! And she didn't bite us anymore.
Oh, man.
So what if there are wolves coming at you? You bite the wolf. That's just like the same idea where you were saying, well, they expect you to try and get away. So if you bite the wolf, it'll be like, oh no, I am the hunted. I must retreat.
His world doesn't make sense anymore.
That's right.
I wouldn't want to put my face that close to a wolf.
Why not? Well, you're putting your arm right down its throat, but you won't put your face there?
That's a limb. That's not my face.
I guess. Okay.
It's different.
Well, you could bite it on the back of the neck or something.
I don't know. I don't imagine I'll ever be in a situation where I need to gouge a bear's eyes out or pull out a wolf's insides.
So maybe you should buy that bear mace instead.
Yeah, maybe. That might be a little easier.
Well, yeah, you went to Nashville. You own cowboy boots. I think they look
super cute. First time around,
cute.
I didn't take them.
Yeah.
I felt like a fool.
Second time around. You walk around Nashville with shoes like some idiot.
It's ridiculous. My boat shoes. Get out of here.
Have you bought cowboy shoes?
Cowboy shoes.
Cowboy boots?
You bought cowboy boots?
Well, I bought cowboy boots a long time ago.
I feel like the only way you can truly own a pair of cowboy boots is you need to take them off of a body. You need to kill somebody.
Well, I didn't tell you how I got them.
Take the boots. That's the only way you can truly own a pair of boots.
Why are you saying this? Where does that come from?
It just feels like this should be a rite of passage. You can't just go and buy cowboy boots. You gotta earn them. And you gotta earn them by taking a life.
Killing a man in a duel.
Yes.
It makes me wonder if I'm like agoraphobic or something. I don't think I am. I think I just f***ing hate people. People don't know how to walk down the goddamn street. When there's too many people, they would just wander into the street. They stop in the middle of the sidewalk and look at the goddamn sky. People don't know what the f*** they're doing.
I think we're dealing with a different type of people, too, like on a Grand Prix weekend, right? Where people are like, oh my God, look at that building. It's so big. Because
I guess they're not from here, like country folk, or just like, you know.
I'm always giving them the benefit of the doubt that they're just like not from here and that's why they're so stupid. So
they're honky tonk folk just looking at the buildings.
just a bunch of honky tonks. Yeah.
Matthew, what do you think of F1 weekend? Did you? I think last year you hightailed it out of town.
Yeah, I like leaving, getting away from it because it's just all I really know it as is traffic and everyone revving their engines in traffic.
Lots of revving engines, mind you. I think I was at work downtown the other day. I want to say Friday night, and there was a motorcycle that just like revved its engine like crazy.
That's the worst.
It was real loud and annoying. But then a whiff of air. I don't know.
A whiff of air
came in.
Yeah.
From the window, and it smelled like exhaust fumes. So I went, oh, smells like summer. Yes.
Smelled like gasoline. Summer.
Yeah, man.
The summer heat.
Yeah.
You know, Vanessa I don't know. Carlton. Maybe.
Wow.
I just feel like, you know, the smell of a gas station reminds me of the summer. The smell of driving down the highway with your windows down, then you get caught in traffic, and then it just smells like exhaust.
Yeah. From those many years where you were, like, washing cars outside of a gas station, like, that's the weird... Just, for me, you know, like, my eyes swelling up from the pollen, that's summer, you know, like...
Yeah, but
seeing,
when your eyes are swollen up, you're not like, yes, summer's here.
No, I'm not. But I'm almost never like, yes, summer's here.
No.
I'm like, I'm so hot. Oh, I'm so sweaty. It's so hot.
In your basic complexion, you're getting a sunburn all the time.
Oh, man. I'm sure I should have put sunscreen on for this. Like, I'm...
There's a skylight.
There's a skylight, and I'm feeling some UV rays.
Especially now I'm picturing you just huffing gas.
Yeah, that's it.
And be like, it feels it's like summer.
And we're talking, and then Sebastian just starts talking about cat penises. And
like he didn't understand where the conversation was going.
You make it sound like it was completely unprompted, but I assume it wasn't.
It most likely wasn't, but it may as well have been. Yeah, exactly. So Sebastian goes on to tell us that they're spiky.
Yeah.
Cat penises.
Cat penises are barbed. Because I believe any cat sex is cat rape.
So.
Because when a cat sticks its ding-dong in there, some barbs come out and, like, lock itself in there.
You know it. And you know it more than anyone else.
Yeah. And Angela could not believe this.
Nobody. I'm sorry.
Because she always thought cats were very consensual.
No.
Lovers.
Shows up at the door. I'm here to court your daughter.
Yeah, exactly.
Nobody believes Sebastian. Not just Angela.
That's right.
The funny thing is, like, in a day and age of, like, just, you know, check everything. Mm-hmm. Like, is this true? We chose to not believe him for probably, like, 2 years. And then one day, just out of the blue... we googled cat penises and we're like, holy shit, those things are spiky.
Yeah.
And you're right. So good for you, Sebastian. You're ahead of the curve there.
Vindicated.
Cat penises. This is your guy.
Yeah, when it comes to cat dicks, I'm the guy to talk to.
Yeah, I remember you saying, like, you know when you hear a cat in the lane and it's like, rah! It's not because it's enjoying it.
No. Yeah. Yeah.
So, yeah. So
all
that's
cat
a
sexes.
Hot summer day story. That
yeah,
makes
feline
me...
molestation. Fun times.
Yeah. Yeah.
We were at this KFC in a food court, and I was marveling about malls.
A lot of strange stuff going on.
I don't spend much time in malls, but I know that malls are not the real world. And the real world is not malls.
This is what you've deduced
in
your 31 years.
Yeah. But before we left, she sort of cut herself off and told us, like warned someone, don't look in there. And there was, like, a whole bus.
Yeah, well, a family walked by and was trying to look.
Into the bus.
Yeah.
And this bus had blacked out windows, and I didn't read the sign on it. I just didn't think that much of it. I thought it was part of the decoration of this safari place.
Yeah, because it was like a safari bus.
Yeah, a safari bus, like a small safari bus. I don't know. It was
like
a tan bus.
Well, it looked like something that had crashed and they just...
Yeah, exactly. And then she took off some sort of like wrist guard thing she had to show us all the scars on her arms and said, well, he gave them to me. And I'm all confused now. I don't know what she's talking about. She's like, well, there's the iguana in there. That's why we had to black out the windows. Like, there's an iguana in the bus? Yeah. How big is he? 5 feet. That's crazy. And then I read the sign. It's as if the iguana wrote it. It's mating season. I'm very agitated. Don't look at me, please.
don't look at me. And very agitated just means...
There's a horny iguana in a bus. Don't look at me, or else I'll try to f*** you.
If this bus is rocking,
please come a knocking, because I'm a horny probably. Iguana.
She did say that it charged the door a few times. Like, sometimes you can just hear it charge into the door.
A 5-foot iguana trying to escape a bus with its blacked out windows. This is all terrifying.
I thought she was joking. I thought it was just one of those, like, it's like, oh yeah, haha. And she's like, that's how I got all my scars. And I'm like, I still think you're joking, but I don't know where you got these scars from.
Either your pet cat or this 5-foot goddamn iguana that's apparently in
there. Yeah, I thought it was just a gimmick, like the blacked out windows, because it's like, if you have a sign on a bus with blacked out windows, and the windows aren't blacked out. The windows have like black paper on the inside that don't completely cover the edges.
You can see
inside
cracks.
A little bit. And it says, don't look at me. I'm going to try to look
at you.
That's
the most tempting thing.
Yeah, I wanted you to distract her. Like, while she was distracted, I tried to like look inside. And I saw that there was like some hay on the ground.
Just threw my keys across the room just to see if we could distract her for a second.
But that's terrifying. That door's locked. If it wasn't locked, I would be very tempted just to open it up and see the chaos that would ensue.
You noticed that it was locked. That's concerning to me that you were ready to just open it up and run away.
I was like, maybe I get a peek in there. I want to see what damage this 5-foot horny iguana. What was it, an iguana?
Yeah. She said
five
it was feet? A 5-foot iguana.
It's
exactly.
Like a Komodo dragon.
Exactly. Imagine this little thing got out, took some man's child, and had its way with it.
Why even have it?
I don't know. That's what I'm thinking. There's a 5-foot iguana that they can't sell. I've been in that mall many times and wandered through that pet shop, and that bus is always there. So why does this place in a mall have a 5-foot iguana with a living in a bus for years on end that no one could look at because it's too horny?
Yeah.
It's weird, Matthew.
It's pretty weird.
You know, this iguana wants to go to bed with someone or something.
Just looking for
probably
love.
Another iguana. Just looking for love.
Yeah. At this point, I think you'd settle with anything.
You know, Matthew, there's some sort of... I've heard about this, like, Rage Montreal or something. Like, it's a place where you can go in and just, like, smash plates and glasses and things.
Oh, that sounds delightful. I think I've heard something about that, but...
I feel like this would be right up your alley. You were telling me while we were eating one time where you were so frustrated, and you darted your eyes around a room and grabbed a glass and smashed it, and it turned to dust.
Yeah.
And then, like, just swept it up.
Yeah, well, I had the time to figure out what would be important to me and what wouldn't, and... The glass just seemed like a good choice.
See, I feel like any frustration that was released from by smashing the glass is brought back twofold and sprinkled with shame when you have to sweep it up.
I can
smash something and then walk away.
Yeah.
That's getting some frustration out.
I don't know. I find it kind of relaxing to clean up. It's like when you're doing dishes, it's relaxing. So when you're sweeping up
kind of nice.
Glass particles out of your carpet and picking them out with the tweezers and stuff, that's kind of relaxing.
Oh, boy. That does not sound relaxing
at all. But that rage thing does sound pretty great. Like just smashing other people's stuff and then they pick up after it.
Yeah.
The only thing I think to make it authentic, it's like you would need to have your girlfriend there just telling you that all of your decisions are wrong.
And Matthew, you're being such a dummy again. It's not actually an impression of your girlfriend, but that's just, you know.
Yeah, they could just have a generic girlfriend. Like, what package would you like? Would you like to just smash stuff, or do you want someone to represent your significant other just disappointed in you or disappointed in your choices or questioning all of your motives? And
why don't you ever want to see my parents, Matthew? And then you just start smashing things.
Yeah, to make it... Because I need to be angry when I go. I can't just go there and rile myself up. I need someone else to do it. I need there to be an instigator.
No, we never switched pillows. That was my pillow all along. And you smash things.
Oh, that is exactly what I need. Because I don't know how they must have something there to get you, like, to really get you heated, to get you going.
I mean, honestly, maybe once you smash one glass or plate, you're like, oh. And then you just start going. I would love to, like, have a crowbar or something. Have, like, a tire iron. Just something I could